OneWeather. OneWeather is arguably the best weather app out there. It features a simple paginated design that shows you the current weather, forecast for up to 12 weeks, a radar and other fun stats. Along with that, you will get a fairly decent set of lightly customizable widgets and the standard stuff like severe weather notifications and a radar so you can see storms approaching. Perhaps its best feature is its minimal design, which just shows you the weather and little else. The UI is easy to move around and the weather fun facts are a cherry on top. The free version has all of the features with advertising. The $1.9 charge removes advertising. Otherwise, the two versions work the same way. Most will also likely enjoy the range of weather fun facts as well when you open the app. Microsoft SwiftKey keyboard is one of the most powerful and customizable third-party keyboards available. It hit the market several years ago with a predictive engine unlike anything any other keyboard had, and the app has grown a lot over the years. It's a free download and you can purchase themes for it if you want to. Other features include a dedicated number row, SwiftKey Flow which allows for gesture typing, multiple language support, cross-device syncing of your library and much more. It's about as good as it gets in the keyboard space. It's true that Microsoft now owns SwiftKey, but so far they have managed not to mess up. Podcast Addict is an excellent podcast app for podcast fans. It features almost every podcast you can think of. In addition, it has a simple and effective UI, plenty of organizational features, plenty of playback and download features, and a single cost premium version. You can browse podcasts by category or search for them individually. You can also set download rules, create playlists easily, and it supports both Chromecast and Sonos along with Android Auto and Wear OS. The UI isn't the most elegant thing we have seen, however the app makes up for it by hitting literally every other box we could think of. PowerAmp is one of the most popular and most functional local music players on Android. It has basically all of the features including high resolution, audio support, Android Auto, an equalizer, gapless smoothing, and support for virtually any audio codec you can find. It even supports devices like LG V60 and its Quad DSE. The UI has a tiny bit of learning curve, but it's one of the better looking music players as well as with optimal themes that you can download from the Google Play Store. LastPass is one of those must-have Android apps. It's a password manager that lets you save your login credentials in a safe, secure way. On top of that, it can help generate nearly impossible passwords for you to use on your accounts. It's all controlled with a master password. It has cross-platform support so you can use it on computers, mobile devices, tablets or whatever. There are others, but LastPass always feels like it's one step ahead. Additionally, the premium version is cheap. You can also grab LastPass Authenticator to go along with it for added security. File browsing is something everyone inevitably has to do, so you might as well do it with a capable, fantastic file browser. Solid Explorer is pretty much as good as it gets in the File Explorer app's realm. It features material design, archiving support, support for the most popular cloud services, and even some power user stuff like FTP, SEPT, WebDAV, etc. It looks great, it's incredibly stable, and it just works well. There is a 14-day free trial with a $2.9 price tag at the end of it. This is by far the best file manager on Android for most people. TickTick isn't popular as other to-do list apps, however, it may be the best one. It covers the basics like recurring tasks, reminders, push notifications, various organizational features and categories. The app also lets you share tasks and entire categories with other people. This makes it great for family use, small teams and other such groups. It's also great for stuff like grocery, honey-do lists or any other list. This app is definitely better than Google apps like Google Keep. You get all of the features for free, albeit in somewhat limited capacity, such as two reminders per task. It's also a great alternative to Wanderlust. Google Drive is a cloud storage solution available on Android, where all new users get 15 GB for free permanently upon signing up. You can, of course, buy more if needed. What makes Google Drive so special are the suite of Android apps that are attached to it. They include Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides, Google Photos, Gmail, Google Calendar, and Google Keep. Between the Office apps, the Photos, and Keep Notes for note-taking, you have apps for practically anything you need to do in terms of productivity. Some of the features of these apps include live collaboration, deep sharing features, and compatibility with Microsoft Office documents. Google Maps virtually owns the navigation apps scene, and it remains of the best Android apps ever. It gets frequent, almost weekly updates that seem to only add to its incredibly generous list of existing features. Aside from the very basics, Google Maps gives you access to places of interest, traffic data, directions to things like rest stops or gas stations, and they even let you have offline maps now. Google also owns and operates Waze. It's unique and fun in ways that Google Maps isn't, and we also highly recommend it. Last but certainly not least in our list is Zedge. This is a wallpapers, ringtones, notification tones, and alarm tones app that gives you an unbelievable number of options to customize the most basic parts of your device. On top of having an exhaustive collection of things, Zedge also promotes various items during holiday seasons, making it easy to theme your phone up for Christmas, Halloween, and other holidays. It's not 100% perfect. It does have the occasional bug and some truly irritating advertisements. Zedge Premium is a new initiative to provide premium content at a reasonable price. You watch ads or fill out surveys to earn Zedge credits as well. So these were some of the apps that qualified for the best apps for 2021. Hope you like them, and if you like them, a sub to this channel would be amazing. And thank you for watching.